Welcome, welcome, welcome to our broadcast here. I'm doing this on my lunch break because I got a breaking news story. It's the biggest news story in history. And this is not overhyping it at all. It's such a big news story that it knocks everything off the front page, off the middle pages, and off the back page. And it's a blessing to everyone, because we don't have to pay attention to any of those other news stories. They're now irrelevant. Totally irrelevant. Okay, so this clarification came to me this morning. And I said, well, I got to get this out to all of you because this is breaking news. This is so important. So fasten your seatbelts. What could be the biggest news story ever? I had never seen this before. But suddenly, it became clarified to me. It froze up. Interesting. It all froze up here. The video froze up. Everything froze up. Okay. I thought I was going to be a piece of cake, and suddenly it froze up. Everything suddenly froze up here. Okay, let's unfreeze it. Jamyang Kenzie Choki Lodro. Jamyang Kenzie Choki Lodro. Unfreeze the technology here. And let us continue with this. It stopped at 13, actually. The computer just froze up at 13. Isn't that amazing? As soon as I started to get into what it's going to be, everything, the mouse doesn't work. The counter, the video doesn't work. Everything's frozen in place. So people are like, the world is like frozen. We can't, no, you can handle this. This is beneficial. So let us unfreeze this and we will roll the dice and see where it may lead to. Absolutely. Okay, so it's now unfrozen. Okay. It's okay. Interesting. It worked. Jamyang Kenzie Choki Lodro worked again. Wow, wasn't that amazing? So we're going to roll the dice, okay, and let the chips fall where they may. Let the chips fall where they may here on this one. So this is all I ask of you, the viewer, the listener, is just say, okay, we're willing to hear this, and let's see what happens. That's my perspective on it. Let the fallout be whatever it is. Boom. Full stop in the wow with this. Okay. Plain and simple. This planet. What is this planet? And everything on this planet. What is it, actually? It's a weapons manufacturing facility. This entire planet and everybody on this planet and bodies, the environment, nature. It's a weapons manufacturing facility. A plant. A weapons manufacturing facility plant. That's all that it is. 100%. And the weapon we are manufacturing here is hope. Is hope. And the purpose of manufacturing the weapon called hope is to try and change reality. That's the purpose. That's all that this planet is. And that's all it's ever been. And that's all that bodies are simply a process in this assembly line of manufacturing hope. They're an essential. It's kind of like the silicon for silicon chips. You need the something which appears to be threatened so you can have hope. So we are all simply workers in this assembly line of manufacturing the weapon called hope. And that's all that this planet is. It's just this warehouse where we are manufacturing the weapon called hope. That's all that it is. So this just knocks all sociology out the window. It knocks all news, other news stories out the window. Totally irrelevant. Totally irrelevant. There's nothing but idle chit-chat from the workers on the assembly line of the weapons facility. It's a total quantum shift, a complete paradigm shift here. This is what I went through this morning, but it's like, wow, that's great. Happy to see this. This is what I came to do, is spill the beans. Tell everybody, hey folks, this is just a weapons manufacturing facility. That's all that it is. That's all it has ever been. And we wanted to have like these little rooftop gardens, like Facebook has. Their roof is a garden. Oh, very nice. So we have a little plaza, like Apple, in the middle of their new spaceship headquarters. You know, it's a green area and trees around. Oh, isn't that wonderful? So we're all busy earnestly trying to make the workers happy here. We have happy weapons manufacturing workers. And what we're going through now is a new CEO, new management team is coming in, because the bigger boss says, hey, you know, you guys are not being quite profitable enough. We want to make, you know, generate more hope, I mean more threat. Without any threat, how could there be any hope, right? We wouldn't need hope without threat. So to generate more hope, you have to have more threat. Hope and threat. Hope and chains. Hope and threat. Hope and fear. Hope and change. All of this is the new CEO management team coming in here and saying, look, we gotta up the production of hope. We gotta up the output of weaponry. When hope's the weapon we're manufacturing here. So this is the big new world order changeover that's happening. The POTUS of the United States is part of the new management team. Generating more threat, more crisis, more threat to generate what? More hope. Hope and chains. It is simply a weapons manufacturing facility. It's all that it is. So that takes all the air out of all our bluster, doesn't it? This is called repentance. This is what a repentant mind ultimately sees and recognizes. Thank you, Jesus Christ. So we'll just let the chips fall where they may here. Some will be dismayed, but ultimately it's beneficial for everyone. Others will just say, yes, I never thought I'd hear this. I know that's true, but you can't say that here. You know, it's taboo. No, it's not taboo. Not anymore. It's just nobody would break the news story. Nobody would break that news story. Because that just takes the air out of everybody's balloon, doesn't it? Because we think, you know, we're super good weapons manufacturers because we're having, like, you know, we're ecologically friendly here. The plant, we got to get this plant running better. All the idealism here just takes the air, takes their balloon, pops their balloon, that's the air out of their balloon. Entirely. Takes the air out of all the balloons here. Deflates. Everybody's ego has been deflated now. Which is great. That's what we need. So this is the big story. This is the biggest news story in the history of this planet. That we actually know what this world is about now. It's a weapons manufacturing facility. And the weapon we're manufacturing here is hope. I hope I don't get hurt. I hope I don't die. I hope I don't have an accident. I hope I get food. I hope that predator doesn't get me. I hope I get find some happiness. I hope I get to buy this. I hope I get some pleasure. I hope I keep breathing. I hope, I hope, I hope. It's a hope manufacturing facility, and hope is a weapon designed to change reality, which is our purpose. We want to prove we're greater than God by changing reality. So we have these weapons manufacturing facilities. And this is just a weapons manufacturing facility put out in some backwater, you know, hillbilly swamp somewhere out in called space. And we're just, you know, busy, you know, working here, just manufacturing all this hope, which is really nothing at all. So I'm kind of tired. This hit me, the shock of it hit me. Really, it started out by I got in the morning and I looked at the Facebook news feed and okay, very good. Got Maharaj and Sagara Maharaj and Sri Sri Nandamaimon, Nyingma Masters and Ram Maharshi and all that. And it was great, good way to start the day. And then I was driving and suddenly I realized I want to. I had a conversation with somebody about Tibet, who often visits Tibet and mountain climbs there. And I saw a picture this morning of Lake Manasarovar or something like that, Mount Kailash. Beautiful picture. And the news feed. And I asked him, I saw him, I said, "Hey, have you been to Mount Kailash?" He says, "Oh, yeah, I circumnavigated it actually." I said, "Oh, really? Wow, yeah, you did it the way the Hindus and Buddhists do it, circumnavigate in the same way I did the whole." He's actually done it. I was like, "Wow." Then he's talking about Tibet. He says, "Yeah, it's really sad there." He says, "Really sad. The Chinese are just super. The Tibetan people are super oppressed by the Chinese. They're not even allowed to learn their own language. You have to learn Chinese. I mean, it's just a terrible oppression there." This is what he told me. I didn't even ask him about it. He just volunteered this. I said, yeah, I hear you. But anyway, then he asked me, where are you going to go? I said, I'm getting in great shape. And he says, oh, good, good. Maybe you got to go. You got to go. Maybe you should go to Mount Kailash or something. And he said, when are you going to go? And I said, I was like, me? I mean, I'm like in the hole as far as money goes. I don't have any a cent for anything. Actually, in terms of paying things going forward, unless I want to put it all on a credit card, which I'm not going to do. Don't have any credit cards anymore. So I was thinking about that after I left him. I said, "Wow, I can't go anywhere." And suddenly, something came up within me and said, "Hey, no, you know where I want to go?" I said, "What?" "I want to go to no place. I really want to visit no place. Not only visit, I want to really go there and experience this. And that no, my destination is no place." And suddenly I said, "Yeah, that's exactly what where I've always wanted to go. I've always wanted to go to no place instead of a place." And so this started this profound realization about no place. And then that led into the sudden recognition of that this world is just a weapons manufacturing facility, is all it is. So it's like a 1-2 punch there this morning. No place. And I got it, it really resonated. So when you get it, don't try to describe it or explain it to those who wouldn't understand. This just makes you fall frustrated and confused. Just take it that whoever you're going to speaking with, they're going to hear it and they're going to get it. They're going to say, "Oh, yeah, wow, that's what I want to go to. Absolutely, no place. We're on the road to no place." Going up the country, baby, do you want to go? Going up the country, baby, you want to go? We're going to no place where we always been before. Yeah, going to no place, which is where we've always been. And we just had this ridiculous notion of places. But really, our home is no place at all. No place. The boundaryless, labelless, definitionless land of no place. And I really felt this so powerful. I want to go to no place. That's my destination. So everywhere I talk to people, they just go vacation here constantly. They're always taking trips here. He said, "There's so many wonderful places in the world." He said, "But Tibet, I would return there." He says, "I would return." He's going so many places. And I said, "I don't want to go anywhere in this world, actually. But where I really want to go is to no place. That really is my desire, to go to no place. Not just a visit, but that I want to move to no place. I want to move there because that's my home. I live in No Placeville, Arizona. All this other stuff has just been, I've just been visiting weapons manufacturing facilities. That's all it is. It's all this world is. So everybody thinking this world is so cool. What a cool place. No, it's a weapons manufacturing facility, folks. That's all that it is. Cut and dried. Inescapably true. So this is, you know, the disillusionment of all disillusionments, you might say. One of the big ones. And so I feel kind of tired. You know, the shock of it has hit me. But I'll be okay. Just let the chips fall where they may. What else can you do? Wow. The good news is, the great good news is that it makes everything else irrelevant. You don't have to follow anything else. It doesn't matter. This is the biggest news story ever. Is this world's been outed for what it really is. We think that we're hiding this, camouflaging this weapons facility, like, you know, it's got camouflage netting over it, so God can't tell where is it. Oh, no, it just looks like a nice planet. Okay, everything should be fine there. This is hilarious. I mean, it's completely blatant what this planet's all about. Completely blatant. And of course, God pays no attention whatsoever to weapons manufacturing facilities, manufacturing hope, because hope cannot corrode reality in the slightest bit. There's no way we can bring threat to reality. So everything's fine with God. It's like we're like children playing in a sandbox. We used to have a sandbox right near where I'm sitting, and I used to love playing in the sandbox. And you get little scoops and you pour stuff. You got the water and you build all these things and have all these trucks and whatever to move stuff around, and it's your little world there. And so you're building this, you know, building hope, this weapon, building weaponry, the hope in the little sandbox. I mean, what is God supposed to be worried about? You're playing in the sandbox? No, we're just idly spending our time doing nothing, actually. It's all make-believe. There's no real threat at all to anything. It's just appearances, shifting appearances, and we're calling it threat. And then having hope, I hope this doesn't happen. I hope this appearance shift doesn't happen. And yet we're controlling all the appearance shifting, trying to manufacture this hope. And then we hope that this hope will change reality. So but for right now, we don't need to try and get into analytical about anything. It's like, this is right. This is just a weapons manufacturing facility. That's all that it is. Every microbe, you know, every plant, everything is involved in this. It's all generating. The plant hopes it gets sunlight here. It hopes that the disease doesn't hit it. It hopes that it gets water. It hopes that it gets fruit. It hopes that it gets fertilizer. It hopes that it perpetuates itself. Everything here is hoping. And so there's just, you know, infinite styles of hope here. It's just a weapons manufacturing facility that Spirit has set up. Has set up many of them. This is just one of them. Again, so this is a complete paradigm shift. Knocks everything else out. When we talk about a knockout blow, this is a supreme knockout blow. Here, a supreme knockout blow. I wonder what'll happen if I mirror this image. I can't bring this up. I can. Let me see. Mirrored. What's going to happen here? Okay. Paradigm shift. See that paradigm shift? All right. It's kind of like that. You see, you're still talking. Communication's the same. It's just the background. See, the background has suddenly shifted here. But I'm still talking. You know, the message is still the same. And it's kind of like that. Right now we realize, oh, wow. And yeah, this is a weapons manufacturing facility. The whole world, that's all there's ever been. Of course. And we test out the weapons on each other and try to generate more hope through all, you know, vulnerability, attack, fear, insecurity, instability, all this stuff. It just generates more hope, doesn't it? Oh gosh, I hope I don't get pulled down. I hope this recession doesn't get me. You know, I hope things will be better. I hope, I hope, I hope, I hope, I hope. Wow. I'm getting very sleepy and tired now. This is almost trying to put me into a shock state. And so it makes everything silly. These activists marching against weaponry in this world, they don't, don't they understand that all bodies, all people, everything here is just a weapons manufacturing facility? Everything. The birds, the animals, the people, the trees, the sky. Every last aspect of this world is engaged in manufacturing hope. So I'm almost falling asleep. This is a sup has a soporific effect. Sleep-inducing effect, to say this, because the taboo is coming up. It's like you can't say this. Wow, it's almost like my speech is being slowed down. That's the shock of breaking this news story. It was very difficult. I'm a maverick. I realize that a lot of the religions are very institutionalized, and there's kind of a set pattern of witnessing and speech and sharing, and it's pretty perfunctory talk, a lot of it. All of the traditions do. Tibetan Buddhists, they tend to listen to them. They all seem to be saying kind of the same thing, sort of like they're reading out of a manual or something. They just have this general spiel which the monasteries, the Shedras, teach. And they all are well taught, just the same way someone be taught at Oxford or Oxbridge. It's just, it's a way of saying, registered English and registered standard. They talk this way, they act this way. They have these areas that are highlighted and important to them. Whew. Same thing. It's almost knocking me out, actually. Can't hardly stay awake. That's amazing. Not surprising. But not gonna go for any coffee or anything like that. Don't do that. Problem with caffeine is, let's say you're swimming up against a current of a strong river, and there's a rock. You're in the middle of the river, and you see this rock in the middle of the river. It's your safety. You gotta get to that rock because you're being swept downstream by this powerful current. So you're swimming against the stream, and you're making a little bit of headway, but slow and tough. But you don't dare stop swimming because you'll be swept downstream. So what happens is, when you drink caffeine, is you put on a burst and you seem to be swimming upstream a little faster, but then you get tired. But at some point, you start thinking, hey, you get confused about which direction is progress, because you feel, I need fast progress, I need fast progress. And then you say, "Hey, wait a minute! If I just stop trying, I'll be going really fast." And you forget which direction you're going fast in, and so you stop trying to swim upstream. What happens? You're swept downstream really fast. So with caffeine or other drugs, you're saying, "Wow, I'm going really fast now. Okay, everything's fine. I'm going real fast." But in fact, you've lost sight of the whole objective, which is to swim against the current. Wow, it's almost like self-anesthetization here. Like I'm anesthetizing myself. So you can't say this. Wow. Trying to knock me out. Man, I was almost knocked out there. Holy cow. I just ate a lot of pasta. Maybe that's, I'm eating a lot of pasta now, so I'm gaining some weight. Maybe that's enough of the pasta. I juiced up like 20 organic strawberries, big ones, last night. It filled up the entire juice container, NutriBullet, big one. Just about. Oh man, and it was just strawberries. And wow, well, maybe a little juice in there. So, and it was intense. I drank the, chugged the whole thing down. Good Lord. I got the scale in the morning. I gained weight, but. Probably got a lot of vitamin C from the strawberries, a lot of something good. But so I'm gaining a little bit of weight. Got to be careful about that. But I want to, you know, make sure I'm not shorting myself with all these workouts. So all these workouts, I'm in such good shape that I'm able to deliver this news message, which is just a knockout blow, and I'm able to, you know, kind of stay barely awake. And but even though I feel weak in delivering it, I know that my, you know, I mean, it's good enough shape that I just feel like, oh, it's not a big deal. Whereas if you're in really bad shape, you might really be worried about it. Say, oh gosh, I don't know, this is too dangerous, too scary. Can't deliver this message like that. Wow, it's almost like an extreme soporific, quiet, it's like kind of come across upon me. I've got to sleep, got to sleep, got to sleep. Wow. So we don't really need to say much about it. I mean, it speaks for itself. This news story just speaks for itself, doesn't it? And it's a game changer. It's a total game changer. But we don't have to chase that down. Don't chase it down at all. It's enough. Realize when you've done the good work, that's enough for right now. When you've done something that knocks you out, recover from it. Okay, say okay, and then we'll get our second wind, and we'll feel recovered, and then we'll take it from there. We'll just take, let the chips fall where they may. We'll just take it from there, and just enjoy the new perspective. Like the whole world's nothing but a weapons manufacturing facility. Everything here, it's all that it is. Now, again, we'll just take it from there. We're not going to delve into it too much, actually. Because I'm feeling this effect from this is just it's really like you can hardly listen, hardly pay attention. It's, everything here, children, parents, people, everything. These are all just part of the assembly line process of producing, assembling hope. Hope is the weapon that we plan to use against God. And it hasn't worked very well. So we want to generate even more severe hope, which means more severe threat, more severe endangerment. Oh God, I hope this doesn't happen to me. I hope this. I feel constantly in a state of, you know, the rich people are always in a state. I hope the thieves don't come in and steal my stuff. I hope I can make more money. I hope this means I'm a good person. I hope I can, you know, go somewhere and do something that makes me feel happy. I hope. Everything is just hope here. Wow. There's a... no question. I'm experiencing extreme reaction from the world. Wow. So intense, I can't. That's amazing. I'm dropping off to sleep and going into a mental scenario, not even realizing it. So you see how this tries to, this information, how you immediately drop back asleep, and when you get this, you can't stay awake to it. It's so difficult to stay awake to it. Really tough. But that's okay. That's okay. Holy Spirit knows all about this. And the clarity is present. It's already been, the news story's been broken here nothing you can do about it. It's just a matter of, okay, start getting used to it. There's, in terms of well, what do we need to do? I don't even think about it. There's nothing we can do in terms of, we just have to see it's completely ineffective. Then we don't need it ultimately. That Jesus said, there's nothing here to value in this world at all, except our creativity, honoring our creativity. So all we do is just honor the creativity of all the decoration of intrinsic spaciousness here. That's all we can do. So weapons manufacturing facility, we've all just been workers on the assembly line. That's it. Stay awake. I keep thinking there's something else I got to focus on. And since it's not here, I keep trying to go to sleep and dream about it. Like I've got to see a different perspective. I know I've got to go back to the old perspective. And so it's trying to put me asleep, literally fall asleep and dream, where then the ego can have, you know, have its way with me of let's look at this, let's look at this, let's look at this. Don't drink any caffeine to stay awake. Just use your will. Oh. God, really very tough right now to stay awake. It's the middle of the day. It's 2 o'clock. Wow. Oh. It's almost like I'm passing out, actually. Pretty interesting, huh? This is why it's so difficult to get this information and news. We all go into a coma, or like we try to keep ourselves in a coma so we don't see this. So I've just come out of my coma, and I'm seeing it, but now there's this tremendous pull just to go back into a coma. Absolutely there is. So don't worry if you happen to slip back and forget about it. Just come back to it. Just start working at this. It's a challenge now to bring yourself into conscious awareness of this. This world is nothing other than a weapons manufacturing facility. That's all that it's engaged in, 100%. That's it. Whew, wow. What a backlash from this. I said I'd do it. I said, Jesus, I'll say it. Well, it's like, oh, okay. Here's the backlash. So I have to use my will here, be very determined. Yeah. Now I'm going to stick it out. It's a done deal. It's too late for the coma. It's too late for sleep. Too late for sleep now. It's lost, missed its opportunity. It's finished. It's finished. It's done. Done. The entire planet is hoping that I fall back asleep. But no. No, no, no. The Dharma King's saying, we need a maverick here to speak this, because you don't get this from the institutionalized religions. Even the really great ones, they all have greatness to them. They pretty much are repeating what their teachers said, what their teacher said, and it's just passed on. And it's like you realize it's all just the same speech. They're kind of giving a campaign speech. Even the Tibetans, you know, it sounds like a religious campaign speech. It's the same speech over and over again from everybody. But nobody's saying that this world is just a weapons manufacturing facility. That's all it is. Nobody's saying that. I've never heard that anyone say this. They're sticking, playing it safe, sticking in the parameters of, you know, what they've been told as far as well, this focus. But so this precludes them from being really creative. And I'm very much a maverick, creative maverick. And it's really funny because just after I had this insight, there's this car in front of me with all these surf stickers on it, and the biggest one right in front of me says Mavericks. Mavericks. And I realize I'm a maverick. So I'm not beholden to any tradition. Because you don't hear this from any tradition, actually. But the world, we need these mavericks that'll speak up, very original, very creative, and say and be able to then see it the way it really is and say it. Because you're not hearing it elsewhere. You're just not hearing this. The world, all of this world is lock, stock, and barrel. The whole thing is a weapons manufacturing facility. And the weapon, the super working on a super weapon called hope, and this super weapon is supposed to be able to change reality. But we haven't quite perfected it yet, so we're still working on it. Yeah, and guess what? It's just building castles of sand. There's no such thing as a weapon against God. So much ado about nothing. We see how I use sleep as a defense, unconsciousness as a defense. Well, when I was dropping off to sleep, I wasn't unconscious. I was dreaming, seeing all sorts of people there talking to me, interacting, saying, "You got real active. I was doing this, stacking some wood here, and doing this, and can you do this?" That's when I experienced when I started going to sleep. Yeah, that's just a defense. Stay busy at manufacturing weapons. Come on, you're just a, but you're just a worker on the assembly line. You're, it's okay. You don't have to worry about what you're working on. Just do this and do this and do this. You're just a robot on the assembly line. The big chiefs, they know what it's all about. We don't really know what we're manufacturing here. We're tightening a few screws, and that's all we're doing. And all compartmentalized, and only the big chiefs know. So nobody, everybody pretends they don't know what they're doing. They're just like, oh, I'm just doing my job. I don't know. We don't realize that we're constantly dwelling in the reaction, emotion, and belief and thought of hope. Constantly. We're living like an ocean of hope. Wow. Fatigue has hit me now so severely. I can barely keep myself from collapsing. This shows you the psychic reaction, the defense systems, psychic defense systems that are in play. But the great thing is we have this news now. And it's what is the 29th? Wonderful. Some people have said the rapture's July 29th this year. Pretty interesting. Something's coming up July 20 from 24th to the 29th. There's a time period in there. Something's coming up the end of July. But it's too late for that something. We stole the march on it here. We stole the march on it. Absolutely. We already so that, so but by all means keep working on this, even though it's a challenge to you. Take it like the greatest challenge in your in history is to get up to speed on this so we don't fall asleep, that we can full of energy. Once we can accept this and the chips fall where they may, and we and the continuity fear evaporates and all this, and we will we'll see what we need to see. Very super positive at that. Then we won't feel de-energized and fatigued and dragged down, because this is what all this fatigue and everything is designed to keep us from realizing this fact. And once we realize it, so I don't need to be tired. I don't need to fall asleep. I don't need to dream. I already know what's going on here. It's a weapons manufacturing facility. Oh, we're all working to camouflage it so much. Gotta camouflage it, and yet it's completely blatant. There's nothing funnier than trying to camouflage this. So take it when you when don't get an aversion to this. Just say, "Oh, it makes me feel I'm feeling sleepy." Why? Oh, that's a defense. Ah, it's a defense against seeing this. We can't let God know what's going on here. God thinks we're all happy little children. Oh my gosh, God, God didn't make the world this weapons manufacturing facility at all. Why would God be making weapons manufacturing facilities that are designed to generate hope, which is designed to destroy God? Why would God do that? It's ridiculous. Almost fell asleep again. Wow. Holy cow. That's crazy. That's just really intense. My gosh. Here I am talking, I'm just in mid-sentence, and suddenly I suddenly shift into a dream. and I'm trying to convince the viewers of something in the dream. So, wait a minute. Now, I got a good night's sleep last night. This is a psychic reaction. Wow. Very interesting. Super interesting. Okay, so you have your news story now with about a month to spare. So we have a month to get used to this. We will certainly get used to this. Absolutely we will. And this will be just incredibly helpful for us. Having already brought this to light, getting over the continuity fear. Engage. I almost went to sleep again. Did you hear that? I couldn't even talk. Get over the continuity fear that in the dreams that are engaged. I was mid-sentence into speaking. I virtually slipped into sleep again. Wow. So the problem is you try to get to this realization, you're using caffeine to cancel out the problem is there's a lot of problems with that. Even if you got here, the backlash would still be there and you wouldn't practice handling it properly. And so you'd be pulled back down and you forget all about it. So it's not just speed, it's speed and establishing the truth here. I can't hardly speak right now. Wow, just went to sleep again. You see that? Good Lord. That is shocking. Wow, this is some of the strongest I've ever experienced. Directly related to this information, this great news story that's been exclusively broken here for the whole world, for everyone. Your intrepid reporter here. Not exactly a piece of cake to break this story. but let's get it up on YouTube. All right? Very great. That's it for now. And we'll catch a second wind on this one soon. All right? Just full stop in the wow it and notice your reactions and pay attention. It should be very, very interesting. All right, that's it.